The idea is to take waste food that's destined for landfill and through the flies, create products that are quite valuable. So today, wanted to share with you part of our research, which is black soldier flies. And in breeding black soldier flies, we're looking to create a true biodegradable polymer that's chitin. And then we'll transform that into chitosan.
Black soldier flies, they're true flies. So they're in the same family as house flies and mosquitoes. And they're particularly unique because, yeah, they break down organic matter and they do it really well. But the larvae are the ones that do the voracious feeding. They can consume twice their body size in a day. So when you have a couple of hundred of those multiplied by a number of adults that put their eggs into a compost heap, they can be extremely efficient at breaking down food waste.
Once the larvae mature, they will go into what's called a pupa stage. Once the adult emerges from the cocoon, what's left behind is very rich in the biodegradable polymer that we're after, namely chitin. And then we can take that through chemical steps to produce the chitin and eventually chitosan. So it's designed to break down and compost into the environment.
So as part of this project, we're not only looking at the science behind black soldier flies, but also how black soldier fly farming can scale commercially. So we're investigating business models in Australia and around the world to see how they fit into circular and regenerative economic models. Not only have we seen large demand for protein products, so feedstock for livestock, poultry and aquaculture, but we're also seeing an emerging demand for FRAS, so organic fertilizer for soil. We're seeing research in lipids, and now we're seeing potentially multiple applications for chitin. There's been a wave of entrepreneurial activity in black soldier fly farming. We're seeing large-scale operations in Europe and Asia and a number of startups in Australia. And not only are these enterprises helping the transition to regenerative and circular systems, they're also generating economic benefits for regions and local communities.
My name is Risa Otake. I'm a master student at Southern Cross University. I'm changing the food diet. Maybe starter, which is fast food for larvae. Also, I changed the ratio of main diet, meat and vegetable, to see how it affects the amount of chitin in black soldier fly. So I hope my study will help to increase the new chitin source in the Australia, also in the world.
So the Zero Waste Cluster is one of the research arms here at the university. Zero waste is often really tapping into that notion that waste is just resources that are in the wrong location or not being fully utilized. You can see here that the leftover calories from a restaurant plate are literally powering our farm. So we're tapping into all of that energy. So circular economy makes sure that we don't put this food straight into landfill, but instead we're able to breed an entire generation or multi-generation of flies and then produce biodegradable polymers, which again addresses another issue where we have synthetic plastics that are getting out there in the environment, causing harm. So closing these loops and allowing resources to go around and around, that's the whole notion of circular economy.